Get ready to match the stars. Bobby Van, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Sarah Kennedy, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Reagor.
Are you ready?
Ready, G. You look terrific, G.
Thank you very much.
Let me see your vest. Let me see.
My vest?
Fantastic. Nice hand for the vest.
May I say how good you were on Tattletales today?
Oh, thank you. Did you see it this morning?
Are you on again tomorrow?
Am I on again tomorrow? No, today was the last day.
Fantastic.
Too bad. Yeah, wow, thank you.
I like the new time, the change.
Yeah, the 10 o'clock Western, 11 o'clock Eastern, and Midwestern.
Midwestern.
Yes, and...
much better.
Helen was funny, isn't it?
I
married a very funny
Helen
lady.
Helen was funny,
funny as
isn't
hell.
It?
Yes.
Say that again, Gene.
We better get on.
Helen, my wife, was funny. Let's say hello to Henry Griffin, Marla Rockland. Hi, Henry. Henry's our champ. He's got $2,500.
Right on.
You happy about that money, Henry?
I sure am.
Have you spent it in your head?
Not in my head. I spent it in my wife's pocket.
Oh, he's going to be challenged now by Marla Rockland. We found out a little bit about her yesterday. She's going to study inhalation therapy.
That's right.
At UCLA.
Mm-hmm.
Is that the medical school there?
It's in the hospital.
In the hospital.
It's a program in the hospital.
You're going to have to be a nurse to do that?
No. Uh-uh.
Would you like to take my temperature anyway? Can you take my temperature? Yeah, while she's taking my temperature,
I'm
you can watch
your pulse.
Oh, that's my pulse. Oh, yeah, my pulse. Roll a film. All right, shall we have a go at it, friends? Push a little button and ask Marla to make a selection.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Here New we go, game. Man. The counterman at McDonald's said, today we're charging double for the price of a hamburger because blank fell into the grinder. Today, we are charging double for the price of a hamburger because blank fell into the grinder. This is a very poorly constructed from a grammatical standpoint. It could should have read, today we are charging double for a hamburger. Or today we are doubling the price of a hamburger because blank fell into the grinder. Or none of these writers went to college. Or you deserve a bite today.
You got a week for this answer?
What are you doing?
Sorry, honey. It's self-explanatory.
Yes.
All right.
Oh, look, now he's writing. Now he's
cheating.
You sneak and everybody's going to know. All of America's going to know.
Charles.
I am not happy. That is terrible.
All right, Marla Rockland.
As the public will soon see.
The counterman at McDonald's said, today we are charging double for a hamburger because blank fell into the grinder.
McDonald.
Old MacDonald.
Ronald
they
McDonald.
Don't like that, McDonald.
Oh, you didn't
there.
Like that answer.
Didn't like the answer because McDonald fell into the grinder.
Well, they didn't like it because she's going to win.
Oh, McDonald. There it is. Marla, that's one for you. Oh, McDonald fell in the grinder. E-I-E-I-O. What do you say, Brett?
What do you say?
I said the clown whose name I can't remember.
Ronald McDonald.
Is that Ronald McDonald?
That's why it took so long. What did you say?
No, just a minute. This is a showdown. I've been accused for weeks on this show, which I love this show, of copying from you. Now, what did you put?
I put the name, the clown whose name I can't remember.
The what?
The clown whose name I can't remember.
All right, now this proves I do not copy. I wrote the clown whose name I can't remember.
Okay, Sarah, save us from this perilous situation, would you please, my dear?
Well, I went to the heart of the matter and said that our cook.
I see, the cook fell into the grinder, yeah.
They're not too thrilled with you, Sarah.
Well, it could happen.
Yes, it could. Sure it could. Now, Richard.
To all meat, patty, special sauce, cheese, pickle, and...
That's the song they say.
Now, no, that's not my card. I had to write that down, otherwise my sons know it.
Do, yeah.
They don't know the alphabet, but they know that song.
Yeah.
The question, please.
The question is this. Today we're charging double for a hamburger because blank fell into the grinder.
Well, I've eaten those hamburgers, and the only way they'd ever charge double is if meat fell.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about. Am I the only one in America who has not eaten one of those? I've never eaten one there.
Oh, you haven't lived.
Oh, they're delicious.
Yeah,
they are not.
Rather eat there than anywhere in the world.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. Of course, also, my son sings that song.
Well, it is true that they don't copy each other, and it is true that there's no way possible that I could copy Mr. Van. Is that true? So I wrote Ronald McDonald.
That's right.
That's poor. That's not bad.
That's not bad, right? Okay, Henry, you're up. Here's your first round question. Now you all remember how great Richard was
in
Hogan's Heroes. You remember
when he played that corporal? I'm Richard, and I don't remember that.
Well, Colonel Hogan said to Richard, he says, "Tonight is the big escape, and we have a lot of digging to do, so please don't drink any beer. I'm tired of you blanking in the tunnel."
Colonel said.
Hey, you were there. You ought to know.
Okay, yeah.
You're digging this tunnel, you see.
Yeah.
And he says, "No beer drinking, please, because I'm tired of you blanking in the tunnel." All right.
Okay.
Anything you say, Private. Oh, you were a corporal.
Look at him. Does he have the nerve? He has been stealing from me for God. Oh, I want to thing.
You finished?
Mm-hmm.
Can I just have a little peek there? Oh, very good. Yes. All right. Ready over here, ready there. Okay. Just about all set, so we'll wander back over here to Henry Griffin and ask him. You saw Hogan's Heroes.
Oh, yes, sure. Very much so.
And you remember the episode when Hogan went up to a corporal played by Richard?
Yeah.
And he says, "Tonight is the big escape. We have a lot of digging to do, so please don't drink any beer. I'm tired of you blanking in the tunnel."
Tinkling.
You said that, Henry.
I won you $1,000, Henry.
I lost my head.
You went to the head.
Bobby, you're up.
I wouldn't touch that with a...
No.
With a 10-foot tinkling, so I wouldn't get it. I said sleeping.
Sleeping in the tunnel.
I'm tired of you sleeping in the tunnel.
Leave him.
Leave him alone. He's a star.
Right.
What do you say, Brett?
Not in everybody's book.
Oh.
Henry, all is forgiven. Come back home. Ringing your bell and or tinkling.
Okay.
Well done. Well put.
Here. Okay.
Charles Melton was wonderful on Hogan's Hero.
Yes, he was.
My mother used to let me watch it when I came home from school.
Yes.
And Charles was the only 48-year-old student in school.
Yeah. I said the noise whose name I can't remember. Burping.
Burping. Okay. What do you say, Sarah Kennedy?
I know what's coming because I said burping.
Burping. All together. If you're going to do it together.
My heart grows weary.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought we were all singing.
Now, you've got to believe me because I was there, right?
Right.
Came straight from the horse's mouth.
Right.
El Burpo.
Burping. All right. Now, the tonight is a big escape. We have a lot of digging to do, so please don't drink any beer. I'm tired of you blanking in the tunnel. Henry said, tinkling. What do you say?
I know Henry said that.
Yeah, he said that.
He said that more than once, probably.
Right, right.
I also said tinkling.
Oh! Well, that's 4-2 at the end of round one. Round two coming up later, but right now this message for you. Hello.
Shall we have a go at it, Fran?
All right.
Shall I push this button? There we go. What do you say, Marla?
I'll try B again.
You want B again? Okay, you've got B again. Only two people do this. Who are they?
Frickin' Frack.
Frickin' Frack, right here. All right. Listen carefully.
You dirty rat.
King Kong's agent said, he says, Kong, baby. Kong, baby, I finally figured out how to get you some new publicity. I've started a rumor that you and Fay Wray are having a blink. Get out of here. Put up, put up, put up.
Canceled our reservations in Encino.
Could you read the question once more without the underwater ballet?
You're not playing.
I still could ask to have it read again.
I'll read it right now. First, Marla. King Kong's agent said, Kong, baby, I finally figured out how to get you some new publicity. Agents talk that way, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I've started a rumor that you and Fay Wray are having a blank.
An affair.
An affair. Okay. What do you think of that answer?
Woo! Well, I like that answer. That's my answer.
That's your answer. I hope we didn't put any ideas in your head.
No, I put one in yours, didn't I? One little harmless kiss from me,
right,
and you've ruined your marriage.
That's it.
Helen won't be on Tattletales with you anymore.
Oh, yes.
No, they were having an affair when
Oh, they were?
Well, you came when he put his arm through the hotel window and plucked her out of the,
Oh, the Empire State Building.
Sure.
Yeah.
Now, they're having a baby.
Oh.
She's a good kisser.
Yes, very. You know, technically, that should be a match, because you couldn't have a baby without having an affair. But never mind, okay.
It is called the baby affair.
All right. Yeah. Now, so that the score at this moment is 5-2. And Henry, you've got to match three celebrities to stay in the game.
Right.
Hey, you could win the game if you matched all four remaining celebrities.
Right.
Ann does not play and Brett does not play. Everybody
else
does.
I can't help you this time, Henry.
The fisherman said, my favorite worm, Harvey, is the world's most talented worm. After he catches the fish, he blanks it. That's how talented that worm is. After he catches the fish, he blanks it. That's right. Fish, my favorite worm, Harvey, is the world's most talented worm. Does everybody understand that? Are you thinking about that, Henry? Okay. After he catches the fish, he blanks it. All right. Okay. Bobby's changing his mind.
He's changing
his mind. Change his mind.
This won't work either.
I'm trying to do my best.
Oh, wait.
Okay.
Can I do... Is it allowed?
Yeah. All right. Now everybody's ready. We'll come over here to Henry. The fisherman said, my favorite worm, Harvey, is the world's most talented worm. After he catches the fish, he blanks it.
Makes love to it.
I don't think they like that, Henry. Well, it's an interesting idea, though.
The old elephant and the monkey joke.
Right. Let's not get too vivid with our imaginations now, because we'll all go bananas. Okay, Bobby.
So. Yes, my answer is worse than his.
What?
Spits it out. I didn't know
that.
Now, he hates answers.
And you
got to
match everybody else to stay in the game. Here we go, Brett.
Oh,
no,
darling,
Brett
I don't
doesn't play.
Play.
Charles plays.
A worm and a fish cannot make love.
Right.
No more than an oyster and a clam. And once an oyster and a clam were making love, and the oyster walked away, and the man on the beach said, "What? I don't understand. A clam and a clam, an oyster and an oyster. Why is an oyster and a clam making love?
Was he in
and
trouble?
The clam said,
"Yes."
The clam said, no, the oyster said.
I told you he was in trouble.
He puts one claw here, and the other claw here, and the
My pearls.
Oh!
Scale. Scale. It should be lobster. I blow it.
Yeah. All right, so Marla, which game do you have? Each of these. Come on down, Marla. Congratulations. Good for you. Okay, now you stand by for a moment while we say goodbye to Henry. Henry's leaving here a richer man than he was when he arrived.
Right.
And you're a splendid fellow, Henry.
Thank you.
$2,500. Henry Griff. Goodbye, Henry. Yeah. All right, well, we'll spin him off. We'll spin this commercial for you, and then you come back and see how Marla's going to do.
Today's consolation prizes are first from the Amity collection of wall and wardrobes, a four-piece ensemble in the vintage pattern, tooled and antique and soft to rest cowhide, all from Amity. And thicker Richard Dial shampoo, the shampoo with special managing agents that leaves your hair soft and manageable with a natural looking shine. And treat your kids to a good hot nourishing dish from the supply of Franco American Spaghetti or SpaghettiOs. They only cost about 15 cents per serving. In just a minute, Match Game 75 will continue with Gene Rayburn and his blank.
Marla Rockland here has won her first $100. She's going to try for over $5,000 now. Marla?
Yes?
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank dust. Now, the answer that group gave most often is worth $500. If you match the next one, you get $250. If you match the bottom one, you get $100. Three of the celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you call on?
Bobby?
Goldust.
Goldust is one.
Brett?
Brett, have you got one?
Oh, what about Stardust?
Stardust.
Richard?
Richard, have you got one?
Bite the Dust.
Bite the Dust. Bite the Dust. Okay. So you got Bite the Dust, Stardust, and Goldust. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do, Marla?
I think I'll go with Stardust.
Stardust. All right. That's the one she's looking for. Naturally, she hopes it's under the $500 response. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal, if you would please, sir, the $100 response. End dust. Now commercial plugs, please. Oh, all right. Stardust is what this little lady wants. Let's find out if it's under the $250 response.
Goldust.
Well, Marla, here's your last chance for Stardust as we reveal the $500 response. Yeah!
Yeah! Isn't that grand?
Isn't this war a scream?
Great.
Oh, that's marvelous. You got $600. Now you're going to play for $5,000. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Now, remember to collect. You've got to match one celebrity. It has to be an exact match. And it's time to choose one now.
I'll stay with Brett.
Brett.
Uh-huh.
Okay. You'll face me, Marla. Brett will write her answer to this. Blank clown. C-L-O-W-N. Blank clown. Okay. Now, Marla, we need an answer from you. One you think will match hers. What do you do with that? Blank clown.
I'm going to say Bozo the Clown.
Bozo the Clown. You know, I got a level with you. I drew a blank on this one. I think this is kind of a tough one. Let's see what now. Bozo the Clown, Circus Clown. I guess there are others, too. Well, Brett, for $5,000, she says Bozo the Clown will match you.
I ran with the easiest. I thought circuses.
Circus Clown. Bozo the. Oh, and there's Bozo the. And you had Bozo the. Well, you win some, you lose some. But you're still a champ, and you're going to play another game now. Shall we meet another player?
Yeah.
Okay, here comes Lynn Grafton. Lynn, you know Marla. So you're Lynn Grafton.
You betcha.
That's Lynn Grafton. Would you believe that,
Lynn?
Where are you from, Lynn?
I'm all the way from New Jersey.
No,
I started out here.
Yeah.
But I ended up in Berkeley Heights, New Jersey, with my husband, who's a stockbroker. And I'm out here to show off our new baby to all my family who've never seen her before.
How old is your baby?
7 months old.
A boy or a girl?
A girl named Carrie.
And Carrie.
And I'm a part-time legal secretary, part-time illegal secretary, and full-time mother.
Well, you know, it's hard to be a legal secretary. You have to know all about, you have to
the
be
legals.
Able, yeah, all that legal junk that they try to confuse us with. And it's so unnecessary. You ready to play?
I'm ready.
We're not. We've got to do a little business here first. Okay. So you stand by, ladies, and we got this little message for you. Pay attention now. Well, ladies, we don't have time to start this game, but that's be the first order of business next time we meet. I'll bang the gavel down. I say the meeting will please come to order, and we'll begin. In the meantime, is there something I can do for any of you here?
Oh, do your Jimmy Cagney.
See, he doesn't have one. That's why I asked him.
You dirty rat.
You don't have you hear the one about the clam?
No. And that was not a porpoise, it was a lobster, and you blew that whole thing there.
Well, I'll be out in my book.
Show called Show Off.
Show Off.
All right?
Right.
And we'll see you next time. Will you join us next time?
Why, are you coming apart?
Yeah, no. Join us next time.
Yes, Match
Game 75, Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for musical chairs next over most of the CBS stations.